Hey, John Samez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got a question here about nanodegrees. So this is something that is a new kind of concept from Udacity is where I'm seeing these. But this kind of begs the kind of bigger question about, like, you know, online degrees, online kind of programs, you know, the usefulness of them. So this question is from Paul, and Paul says, "Hey John, thanks again for posting all the resources and tips. It really encourages me. I wanted to get your thoughts on the Udacity Nanodegrees. There are three individuals who have just finished the degree and have obtained jobs, the first few that signed up for them, all from different life circumstances." And he links to this blog post here that talks about internships people landed from these nanodegrees. So he says, there's the article. "So the course that Udacity offers are free, but the projects they guide you through to get the degrees are not. I just want to hear your thoughts, or maybe a video, since this could be an option for many. Thanks again, Paul." So a little bit of background on what these nanodegrees, this Udacity thing is. So essentially it's like, you know, an online degree, right? It's not like as large as a 4-year degree program or anything like that, but it's basically a certification, but it's maybe a little bit stronger than a certification. Like, Udacity allows you to take classes online in software development topics, and they're a little bit more formalized, right? They're sort of like this mix between a hybrid, or between a classroom learning and a totally just, you know, online training type of thing. So they're a little bit more rigid and have projects and whatnot, and could carry a little bit more credential. So I think they're a good idea. You know, I think that the traditional education system is going to fail. Interestingly enough, someone expressed this better than I could ever express this. I was just reading the book Anti-Fragile, and in the book, the author, he says, someone asked him, I think, you know, they sent an email or sent him a letter and said something about, you know, "What do you think about traditional education?" Because he's talking about the fragility of systems. They wanted to know, like, what does he think is going to happen with traditional education? And he said, "Bullshit is fragile." So what that means is basically that that he thinks that the system will collapse because it's based on BS, and I totally agree. I think all of the academic systems that we have today are complete BS. Just the academic society in general, you know, it's a lot of BS. And so when I see things like these online degrees where people are actually doing projects and actually accomplishing things, and they're not being reamed for thousands, you know, tens of thousands of dollars, so someone with a, you know, prestigious title can tell them how to think in a very uniform way, and be a robot like everyone else. I like those things. I can't speak for this program myself because I haven't gone through this program. I don't know what it entails. I don't know, you know, what the degree, but I can just say in general, online education is good because it puts more of the focus on learning things, on actual doing, rather than, you know, getting some just some knowledge in your head or just making it through a thing, right? So the key thing is always going to come down to this, and I'm always going to say this in my videos, I'm always going to say this in my blog posts, is that you need to actually do and learn, right? It doesn't matter if you get a degree. It doesn't matter if you get a certification. None of that stuff matters. What matters is when you sit in front of a computer, if you're trying to get a job as a computer programmer, can you program? Can you do it? Can you think? You know, and specifically, I would ask, you know, do you know how to teach yourself, to self-educate, to be able to improve your skills on your own? Or do you need someone to spoon-feed you information? If you need someone to spoon-feed you information, you're going to be in trouble, because whatever I spoon-feed you today is not going to be good for tomorrow, right? You're going to have to figure out, how do you develop and learn your own skills? How do you develop yourself and continuously improve yourself over time? So, you know, all that is basically to say, yes, I like this. I don't know about this exact degree program, but I like this idea. I like the idea of breaking out of traditional education. I like the idea of getting rid of these long-standing kind of gatekeepers for education systems, and saying, okay, there's a better way. What we want to focus on is actually learning that we don't care about where the thing come from, that accreditation is not so important. When it comes down to it, can someone actually do the work? Can they actually accomplish their goals? Can they actually, you know, achieve what needs to be done, right? At the end of the day, businesses hire programmers not to be theoretical and to, you know, be prestigious, but to write code. So can you write code? Can you write good code that can be maintained? If you can do that, if you're doing something that's going to teach you to be able to do that, that's what's valuable. So seek the things that are valuable, and you know the rest will follow. Because you can have credentials and you can have all these things, and that might get your foot in the door. But when you go down to an interview, or even past that, when you actually sit down at your job and actually have to do your job, if you can't do it, you can't BS that. You can't fake that. Like you've got to actually be able to do it. And that's what's going to, you know, in the long run, that's going to be what's important. So focus on those things that are going to be investments in the long term. Anyway, good question. Definitely curious to see where this goes with Udacity and these nano degrees. I'll be following it. Thanks again, Paul. And if you have a question, you can always email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And as always, subscribe to the channel and you'll get more videos just like this one. Take care.